Hi, I'm JP Trin, I'm a WeWeb developer, and in this video, we are going to see how to implement a signature pad in WeWeb. This feature is useful for allowing users to sign official documents, invoices, and more directly inside of your application. Let's dive in. To implement this feature, we are going to use the signature pad library made by Szymon Nowak. Signature pad is an open source JavaScript library for drawing smooth signatures, and you can get the link down below. So let's jump into WeWeb. To use this library, we first need a Canva tag inside of our page. To do that, we can use the HTML component and add our Canva tag inside of it. And I'm going to style the HTML tag. I also need to add a little bit of style inside of my canvas so that it displays well. You can also transform that as a component so that it's easier to use and to maintain. Now that we have everything that we need, we can go inside of the NPM plugin and install the signature pad. I have mine already installed, but you can go and type signature pad, find the one made by Szymon Nowak, click add. Now that the library is installed, we can go ahead and initialize the signature pad. To do that, we can head over to our component, and inside of our component, we can select the Canva and have a new workflow that will be triggered on mount. And I'm going to add a little bit of time delay at the beginning so that the NPM plugin has the time to load before we use the library. I've noticed that without that, it wasn't working very well. And now that we have this, we can add a new custom JavaScript. And we're going to call that initialize pad. Inside of that custom code, we're going to do a few things. First, we need to identify the target that will hold the signature pad, and that will be the Canva tag that we just created. So we are declaring the Canva, and we are going to use this instance, but we have to be careful because context.thisInstance is actually the HTML component. So inside of this element, we need to look for our Canva tag. Now that we have this, we can go ahead and initialize the pad. To do that, we can head over to the documentation. We are going to need the second line here. So we are declaring a new variable and creating a new instance of the signature pad. But instead of using the signature pad like this, what we are going to do is use the method that is located inside of the NPM on the function tab. And I'm going to get rid of the parentheses that are added with that. And just like that, if everything works, we should have something displaying on our pad. So if I reload the page to trigger the onMount event, if I try this pad, we can see that we have our stroke, but it's not yet displaying properly. And we have to go a bit deeper. Inside of the documentation, we have this little function resize canvas. So this function allows the canvas to display properly on the screen. So what we can do is just copy this, head over to our initialize function and pass that after what we have. And if we go and reload our page to trigger again the onMount event and we try this out, it's displaying well, and sharply. And that is great so far, but we still cannot use this component because we have no way to have access to what's inside of the pad. But to solve that, what we need to do is a way to access the instance. And we are going to do that by creating a new variable, a new WeWeb variable that will allow us to have access to everything that's inside. And so if we go back inside of our function, what we are going to do is create a new variable that we hold the instance. To do that, what we can do first is create a new variable. This will be of type object, and we can call that signature path. And we can expose that outside. And back to our function, we are going to use the following method, context.component.methods.update variable. This method allows us to affect a new value to a variable that is copied inside of our component. So the first parameter that we need is the ID of the variable. We can get that by going back to our variable and hit copy ID. And the second parameter that we want is the value of this new instance. So in our case, it will be signature pad. And if we try this new function by reloading the page, and if I head over to the variable tab, we can see that from the elements we have our variable signature pad with a lot of information. That's not really relevant for us, but we are still going to use the signature pad to access our instance information. One thing we can do before going to the next step is customizing our signature. If we go back to the documentation, we can see that we can add options to our initialization and we can modify the struct. So I'm going to copy what's inside of the documentation. And if I head back to my initialize function, I can just add the options there. And if I reload the page, we can see that the struct is a bit thicker and now it's blue. That's awesome, but now the next step is to actually retrieve what's inside of the pad or retrieve the signature. And basically what we are going to replicate is this method signaturePad.toDataURL, and this allows us to save image as PNG. So I can go ahead and copy that, and if I go inside of my component, I can create a new workflow. Let's call that DataURL, and I'm going to create a new return value action. As a value, what we want inside of the JavaScript tab is to return this. But instead of having the signature pad variable like this, we're going to use the one that we created earlier. And now we see that the return value is a string, and this string is actually the PNG image formatted in base64. And if I go ahead and see what this image is, we can see that we have our signature. And that's what we're going to use to store it anywhere else. Right now, this value is only inside of this workflow. But what we can do is create a new variable that we can call signature, expose that outside. And at the end of the workflow, what we can do is change the variable value of the signature with the value that we have on our first action. And if we try everything, we can see that in our signature variable, we have the image. What we want now is a way to retrieve the signature without having to manually do it inside of the workflow. So we need a way to trigger the workflow we just created, but outside of the components. So to allow that, we can toggle this allow execution from outside. And now we can create a button let's call that get image, and that button can trigger a component action. It can be our signature pad and data URL, so that every time we modify the signature and we click on get image, it will update our signature. In real life, it's not really what we want. What we will want is that the signature would update each time the user finishes the signature. And we'll get to that at the end of the video. But first, now that I've done a bunch of scribblings out of my pad, I don't actually have a way to clear things unless I reload the page. So let's solve that. We're going to use this clear function. It will work the same way as the data URL. I'm going to go back inside of my components and I'm going to create a new workflow. Let's call that clear. And I'm going to create a custom JavaScript and I'm going to pass what we had. And instead of the variable, I'm going to use our own instance. And again, I'm going to allow execution from outside. And if I duplicate this button, let's call that clear. This button will trigger the clear action of the components. And if I try that, then it's working well. So that's it for the clear function. The last thing that we want to do now is each time the user finishes his or her signature, we want to update our signature variable. And luckily for us, the signature pad library has a bunch of events. The one that will be of interest to us is the end stroke event. So each time the user finishes a stroke, the variable will be updated. So I can go ahead and copy all of this. I can go back to the initialize workflow and I'm going to add a new action with a custom JavaScript block. And I'm going to pass everything that I had. So I don't actually need the first line. And instead of this variable, we are going to use the one that we have. Instead of begin stroke, we want the end stroke event. So now each time the user finishes a stroke, for now it will log a message. But what we want instead of this console log is to trigger this data URL workflow. And for that, just like for the update variable value, we have this context.component.methods.executeWorkflow that allows us to execute a component workflow. And as a parameter, what we need is to retrieve the ID of the data URL workflow. And let's pass that here. If I reload the page to again trigger the onMount events, if we look at the variables for now, at the initial state, we don't have anything inside of our signature variable. And if I begin and write something, and if I release the mouse, then we have a new data inside of our variable. And if I go back to my interpreter here, we can see that we have the new signature. So that's how to implement the signature pad library inside of WeWeb. We learned how to initialize the components, how to use the methods to get the data and to clear the pad. I hope that you liked it and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.